Eladias, Professor Knestor Jackdaws, enjoying the sun of the Caribbean on this beautiful island here, Klein Bonaire, which is a German word which means little Bonaire. And as you can see, it's an extraordinary day, a typical day in the Caribbean. Beautiful cerulean blue, and you see all kinds of blue, don't you? You see a warm blue, you see a cobalt blue, an ultramarine, a phthalo blue, a cerulean, as I mentioned before. So many shades and nuances of blue. And in such an environment, dears, when you're here, as I am, in person, the urge to create some art that reflects this beauty, to communicate, in fact, what this beauty gives to me is undeniable. One feels the urge to communicate it. It's not enough to just sort of enjoy it for oneself, although that is very pleasant. One wants to transfer it, to communicate it to others. And I believe that's the impetus for so much art, is finding beauty in nature, absorbing it, you know, processing it, and communicating it to others by painting, sculpture, tapestry, poetry, or indeed, YouTube videos. One thing that's so impressive always to me about the Caribbean are the multitudinous coral formations that one finds discarded as the detritus of the sea along the shore, or detritus if you want to be absolutely formal about it. For instance, these beautifully carved bits of what once was living coral, now smooth and shaped by the surf. And this one reminds me, doesn't it remind you of the beautiful hand shape? It's lovely, isn't it? It's very graceful, very feminine. It almost looks as if it's a shard of some ancient Greek statuary. But of course, it's not completely organic. Here's another lovely, you know, these you find in profusion. I believe this is a species of brain coral. What is the capital of Syria? He's right, Damascus. And these are everywhere in profusion as well, these long tubular sorts of coral, now hard as granite. And, you know, they're absolutely ubiquitous. In other words, they're everywhere. There's lots of them. And they remind me, first of all, they have a lovely sound. And they also have a shape that's sort of reminiscent, don't you find, of Dali's crutches that he put under his slowly putrefying compositions, you know, these huge figures that would be resting on a kind of a crutch as they slowly decayed or were covered with ants or looked like something else, like a matador's head or something. These are everywhere. They're very charming, and one wonders if the genius of Salamanca hadn't himself spent some time in the Caribbean and absorbed these wonderful pieces of organic sea iconography. Something to think about. Oh dear. From the Caribbean, I'm Professor Knestor Jackdaws. Ta-ta! Sandy's hat. Hey!